Hey, you guys, I'm so excited today to talk to you about the vital behaviors. Now, your job as a coach is just to become a better version of you. How cool is that? That literally your job is to become fit in every area of life. Now, I think what happens when coaches become coaches is that they think that they have to be perfect, that their workouts have to be perfect, their nutrition has to be perfect, their lives have to be perfect. I need you to understand something. You are the most relatable when you share the real, not the highlight reel, but the real, your struggle with the solution. You're being stuck and how you're getting out of it. That these four vital behaviors are the breath. They are the life of your business. And that if you can just do the four vital behaviors, that you are setting yourself up for so much success, to feel your absolute best, but to also show others what's possible. As a coach, what I think is really incredible is that the only way to be successful is that you work on yourself. The only way to build a really strong business is to make sure that your self-care is a priority. So for our four vital behaviors, the first one that I want to talk about is being a product of the product. And what does that mean? That means you drink your Shakeology daily. And the more you learn about Shakeology, the more you realize how incredible this shake really is, that it is your multivitamin, that it will make your body thrive, that you will feel so good with it. And then working out, following a program, start to finish, and sharing your journey as you do that. So with Shakeology, this is not what we mean by being a product of the product. That you drink Shakeology and then you hold up a shaker cup and you go, Shakeology, it's the best. To be a coach and to be a successful coach with multi-level marketing, with direct selling, with Beachbody, is that you are the product, that you are the life of your business. Not highlighting Beachbody or Shakeology, but the belief that you have when it comes to it, if that makes sense. So instead of going, Shakeology, I would hold up my shake and just talk about how I have more energy, that I used to go to Starbucks every single morning and I used to eat really unhealthy. I love that I have something that's quick and really nutritious. I love that I have a multivitamin. I love that my body is thriving from the inside out. I share my experience, my testimony with why I love what I do. And it's the same when it comes to the workouts. You will not see me say, oh, Insanity Max 30. I'm not trying to brand Beachbody. I'm branding myself. So something that I would say with being a product of the product is, oh my gosh, you guys, being so busy, it is amazing to get a 30-minute workout in and do it from home. I love that my workouts are quick and effective. I love that I can get fit by simply just being in my house. So I share my experience and why I love the workouts, not anyone else. Someone might do the workouts at the gym, but for me, when I was an overworked, burnt out teacher, to be able to do a 30-minute workout in my classroom after school was everything. And so that is how I'm a product of the product, that I make sure I work on myself, and then I'm going to share my own experience while getting fit and invite people to do that alongside of me. So with Beachbody and with being a coach, you have to understand that the only thing that is going to separate you and 400,000 coaches is you. So don't brand Beachbody. Don't use those pictures that Beachbody makes, right? The stock photos. Share you, share your experience, share your life and be in your photos and talk about how it's transforming your life. And so another thing is, I love Energize. I think Energize is life. So instead of saying Energize, I call it superhero juice. I talk about how it is the secret to my workouts. And if you look at my Instagram stories, you'll see that I have, Energize on there every single day. And so I brand me, and you have to understand that the products of Beachbody are your tool belt. That's the way you can help other people. That's the way that you can get yourself fit in every area of life. But you have to understand that people need to be sold on why you love it, on what you do, on why this is transforming your life. They can find Beachbody products anywhere. And so when you are a product of the product, please remember that. As you are sharing being a product of the product, share about your experiences and not sharing Beachbody, if that makes sense. So vital behavior number two is personal development. I also like to say professional and personal development. Now, this is such a game changer. You have to work on your mindset because after all, you are going to have people maybe judge you. You might have worries and doubts and insecurities. Personal development is going to be the thing that allows you to dream bigger. It's going to show you how to dream bigger, and it's also going to give you the motivation. It's going to give you the mindset to be able to build a successful business, but also crush your goals. That you're going to be able to see that you are capable of so many things, that there really isn't a scarcity when it comes to success and happiness, that you can create that for yourself, but it is so vital that you continue to raise the bar on your own life of what's possible. So for personal and professional development, what I mean by that is I love personal development for motivation. So something like quote of the day show, confidence podcast by Trish Blackwell. I like a bunch of different podcasts, or I really love the book The Compound Effect. I really love The Charged Life. I love Girl Wash Your Face. I love I Am That Girl. I love these books that I can listen to or read, and these podcasts that I can listen to for motivation. But for professional development, I also love doing this daily as well, where if I'm feeling stuck on having conversations or hitting Success Club or growing my business or social media, I don't know how to expand my network. I don't know what Emerald means. I don't even know what Shakeology is. I could go to YouTube and click in Shakeology Facts and learn more about Shakeology so I become better at being able to teach other people. And especially with business, there are so many tools out there to help you become better. So something that's really cool with personal development is that I don't like to keep it to myself. So I also really encourage you as you are growing to share that. What are you learning with personal development? What quote stuck out to you? And you can share that in a post, but also you can make your challenge groups around the personal development that has drastically changed your life. I think that that is pretty awesome. So as you do that, so for example, I really love 10X rule. And I love The Charged Life, like I had said before. So I can make a group about The Charged Life, which is really, really cool. So personal development is so game-changing, where if you think about it, the workouts change and transform our bodies. The nutrition transforms our bodies. We need to make sure that we're transforming our mind, because what's going to happen is that you might have naysayers in your life, and naysayers are the people that love you, but they project all of their insecurity and worries upon you, that they are so worried about you failing that they're going to tell you not to go for it. And it's really important that you understand that these naysayers love you, but you have too many dreams to dream, that you need to just keep going, and personal development is going to help you with that. Also, you might interact and be able and come across some haters, people that genuinely do not want you to be successful, that their number one goal in life is to suck the life and energy out of anyone who wants to be happy. Those are people you don't need in your life, but personal development is going to help you get the tools and confidence to be able to understand that everything that they say has nothing to do with you and everything to do with them. Honestly, you guys, I wouldn't be able to say that with such confidence if it wasn't for personal development. Another reason you might have a hard time with success as a coach is yourself. That your own worries, your own doubts, your own limiting beliefs can totally be overcome with personal development. That you'll be able to see that there's limitless possibilities, that you can do anything and be anyone, and that personal development seriously gives you the tools to be able to continue to crush it. A third vital behavior is inviting. And I would say that this is probably the hardest one coaches endure, just because it seems really scary. That you don't want to be salesy, that you don't want to come off a certain way, you don't want to pressure people. Just don't be that person. If you're worried about being salesy, more than likely you're not going to be salesy. Inviting to me is this: being me, believing in other people when they don't believe in themselves, and just telling someone they would be good at this too. And with inviting, I really feel like it's joining alongside you. That sometimes if you put this pressure on inviting, maybe it's the nerves of not being a good mentor and you don't really know what you're doing. You're new, so you feel like you have to be further along in order to invite, right? That you're not at your goal weight, then so you should wait till you are and then invite. No, I think you believing in this should give every reason for you to tell other people that they should do it with you, that they should join alongside you because these workouts are transforming your life, that this nutrition has changed the game for you, that this community is the most uplifting place and space that you've ever been a part of. And you have to think about that. Man, other people need this too. So if you look at it like that, inviting is seriously such a beautiful gift to give. Now, inviting is the thing that's going to move the needle in your business. The workouts and shake and personal development is for you, but inviting, as far as if you want financial freedom, you want other people to experience these workouts, inviting is the only way to make that happen. So let's make inviting less scary. And the way to do that is to share your own experience, to share your testimony that when you believe so much in this, it's easy to talk about. It's easy to sell something when you absolutely love it. I love the candles from Bath & Body Works. Oh my gosh, the spearmint eucalyptus, the stress relief, I could sell that every single day. I don't get any commission for it, but I truly believe in it and I think it's absolutely incredible. I love a bunch of different things. I have a rebounder, which is a small trampoline. I'm obsessed with it. It puts me in such a good mood. It's fun. It's easy for me to talk about and easy for me to sell. I get zero commission for talking about it. But with Beachbody, there shouldn't be a difference. Maybe you really love Target or you really love this book you're reading and you recommend it to other people. Maybe you found the best jeans that make your butt look amazing and you tell all your friends about it. But why is it easy for you to talk about when you're getting zero commission from it? Because you believe in it. So with Beachbody, it should be the exact same thing. Just because you get commission and you get paid for literally transforming lives, freaking cool, it shouldn't be any different. Your belief is enough for inviting. So as I invite, it's always because of my own personal experience. It's because I see vision. I know it's gonna happen. And I get it. You may not be making income yet with Beachbody, but the cool thing is, can't you see that you're capable of doing that? So even though I was making $0 or $4.99 a week or $38 a week with Beachbody, it didn't matter. My bank account did not reflect my heart for what this was doing for me. So it was really easy to talk about and to believe in other people to do it with me. And all I would do was I would say, hey, this is transforming my life. I want you to do this with me. You don't understand. This community is absolutely encouraging. I know you're feeling a little stressed at work. I really feel like this would be a good fit for you. I would love to tell you more about it. It's never really about what you say, but it's how you make people feel. And I talk about my groups all the time. I talk about this team all the time. I talk about these workouts all the time because it's transformed and changed my life. And if you became a coach, it's transforming your life too. You said yes for a reason. And I bet it wasn't because someone was super salesy to you. I bet someone was super genuine with you. And I want you to think about how you got started. How I got started was I heard about the community and I was like, I need that. I need that community. And this community has changed my life. So it's easy for me to talk about the community. So why did you get started? Did you get started because of a group? Did you get started because of your coach? Did you get started because you saw some really empowering positive posts on social media? Remember, there can never be enough joy, enough love, enough positivity. So keep spreading it, keep being the light, and show other people what's possible. Also, I think people just want to sit and relax and watch to see if you are really serious about this. It's almost like people expect us to fail, so they probably do want to join you, but they really want to see if you're going to stick it out. So my biggest piece of advice is this: do not guarantee your failure by quitting. Just keep going, keep showing up, even when that person that you think would be the best for this tells you no. Just take it as a not yet and keep on moving forward. You've got this. The last fourth vital behavior is recognition. I love this. I think it's really cool because I don't think a lot of adults get recognized the way that we recognize adults with Beachbody. It's pretty incredible. So recognition can come in different forms. You're a challenger that's rocking it in your group and you make a post about her or him, and you make a recognition post in your challenge group about your challenger. You can recognize coaches, recognize even if they're not your coaches, someone on the team that you see that is just crushing it. You're building up other people, celebrating them for the process, not just the reward. My biggest piece of advice is this: don't just celebrate people when they hit milestones, celebrate them that they are just on this journey. So maybe someone's completed 5 workouts in a row. Maybe one of your coaches posted on social media for 2 weeks in a row. Give them shout outs, praise them. Overserve. Keep depositing all of that love, all of that encouragement, and it is going to transform the way you feel about coaching. And I'm going to end with you on this, that I really do believe that with coaching, the more you empower, the more that you build up, the more that you connect with other people on this team, the more your life will transform. That when you are a part of this team, that you don't just sit back on the sidelines, but you start to get to know people. And how do you do that? Start welcoming new coaches to the team. Start liking other coaches' posts in the team page and start reaching out to coaches. Ask whenever you see someone going at what you would think a faster pace than you, instead of being envious and jealous, reach out to them, ask them what they're doing, be inspired by them, that their success should only be proof that you can have success too. These 4 vital behaviors are the lifeline of your business. If you think about vitals, right, with your body, vitals keep you alive. This is what will keep your business alive. It's really simple. It's 4 simple behaviors that are going to transform your business. And if you feel yourself you're stuck, I always give myself a gut check. How is my self-care? How are my workouts? How is my nutrition? How is my personal development? Because you are not gonna be able to invite if you're not working on yourself. So being a product of the product and personal development is the segue, the bridge to inviting, getting results, right? And it doesn't mean just physically. It means mentally, it means emotionally, it means socially, it means in every aspect. Then it's easy to invite because you have a transformation of some sort, if that makes sense. And then you invite and then you celebrate all of the people that are doing this with you. Thanks so much for watching. Let me know if you have any questions. I really appreciate it. And hey, you are enough. There's more than enough success for you, and you can do anything with this business. Talk to you later.